And hello, everybody. This is Jack from tofluency.com, and welcome to this live lesson on Thursday. It's on Thursday instead of Wednesday, and I'm going to talk about why in a second. But first, if you are new here, then welcome. This is called the Tofluency Show, and it's where you can learn English live on YouTube. You can also watch the replay, but I do prefer if you come live. This way you'll be able to interact with me in real time, ask me questions, I can ask you questions, you can practice your writing, etc. So if you are new, click that subscribe button. And next to that button, there should be a little bell, and that will give you a notification. And it means that you should get a little email or a notification on your phone when I go live. But the schedule is every Wednesday at 10:30. We've got a lot of things to cover today, but first, let's see who is here. So, let me bring up the comment section. We have Tata, Mustafa, Rosario, Tata again, Ana Rodriguez, it's hard to say. Falaz is here, Parvana is here from Azerbaijan. Guys, let me know where you're from. Rodolfo, Ekaterina is probably from Russia or the Ukraine, I'm guessing. Renato from Brazil. Julio is here as well. We've got someone from Frankfurt. Very cool. A bunch of people joining. Ilkin is here too. Someone from Budapest. Teacher Estela Berra is here. Great to have you back. Other people from Argentina and Serbia. Pinar. Ator from Brazil, a bunch of people joining live. Fantastic. South Vietnam, Turkey. We have, at the moment, 50 people watching live. These live lessons usually have about 150 people watching live. So this is great fun. You can join other English learners and learn English in a fun way. Now, like I said, and let me bring up my presentation. Are you ready? Here it is. This is a live English lesson. This is a picture of me from, I think, about 3 years ago, 4 years ago. Do you think I look different now? Do you think I look different? I think I do. I had a different haircut. You know, I was a little bit younger. I just look a little bit different, I feel. But all is well. I'm still the same person. And like I said, this is every Wednesday at 10:30 a.m. Except for today, because of what I'm about to explain. But take a look here to fluency.com/live. You can go to this URL. Okay, this URL. And it will redirect you to the live lesson for that week. So if you go to that web address, to fluency.com/live, it will direct you or redirect you to the YouTube page for the live lessons. Did you see my Facebook video from yesterday? Did you see this video yesterday? It was a very short video, about 45 seconds. This is not the best image of me, but sometimes I like to take strange images and take a screenshot of it. But I made this video from my car, and I was in the parking lot where my son goes to school. And I had a little bit of a strange morning. In fact, I thought the morning was going really well because I managed to get my son ready for school early, and I dropped him off at about 8:20. Which was great. Usually it's like just before 9, just before school starts. But I got him there early yesterday. I dropped him off early. But then what I realized, I gave him the wrong lunch. I gave him my lunch instead of his lunch. So I went back to the school to swap the lunches. And then when I got in my car, I turned my car on, but, and here is the phrase, my car wouldn't start. My car wouldn't start. So we're using would not for the past here. And we're using it for the past of will. Because in the video, okay, in the video, I said this. My car won't start. So in that moment, I said, my car won't start. My car won't start. And when we're using will for the past, in this situation, we use wouldn't. So my car wouldn't start. And this is a great phrase to know. My car wouldn't start. I'm going to have more phrases for you soon related to this, and you'll be able to understand it more clearly. But I just want to say hello to people in the comment section. You look a little bit different, yeah, but you're more experienced than before, right? I am more experienced, you're right. It's a good way to say it. When you're older, you can say, well, I'm wiser and more experienced. Okay, it's a really good thing to say. Bassam, let's not talk about business deals in the live chat. A couple of rules for the live chat. No, hey, let's chat on Skype and give in your phone number or your Skype address. No, hey, join my Facebook group or my YouTube group. If you're here live, like most people do, just chat about the topic. For example, Petter says, why wouldn't your car start? I'm going to talk about that in a moment. A great phrase, Pedget, why did your car break down? So when your car breaks down, it means there's a problem with it and it won't start. Thank you for the comment, Julio. Bassam, remember, no business deals in the chat. No business deals in the chat. I don't want business partners. Try and keep it on topic. Ryan says you're more mature. Thank you very much. So let's go back to this phrase here where we're talking about cars starting and not starting, okay? Because I said my car wouldn't start. In that moment in the lesson, when I was sitting in the car, I said, my car won't start. Have a look at this. My computer won't work. My computer won't work. So in the moment, we use will. My computer won't work. In the past, my computer wouldn't work. My computer wouldn't work. Now, to continue the story, people asked, what was wrong with your car? Why wouldn't your car start? Well, AAA came and they fixed it very quickly. Now, AAA is a service that you can sign up for and they give you roadside assistance. So they will come, you pay a yearly fee, and amazingly, we joined AAA last week. So we actually joined this program last week. And you might have something similar in your country. Let me know if you do. But they give you roadside assistance. So if your car breaks down, using that great phrase that Pedja, I think, used before, if your car breaks down, then they come and they see if they can fix it really quickly. If they can't fix it, they will tow it to a mechanic. But AAA came, or the guy working for AAA came and fixed it very quickly. There was a problem with the front battery and he just did a couple of things and it worked straight away. So I felt very relieved. I feel very relieved, okay? But they came and they fixed it very quickly. Now, just using this verb fix, I want to talk about something else. Look at this sentence now. I need to get the car fixed soon. I need to get the car fixed soon. This is quite an advanced phrase, and we use it like this. I need to get something done, or I need to have something done. I need to get something done. I need to have something done. I need to get the car fixed soon. And we use this when we're talking about someone else doing something for us. And one of the best examples to help you think about it is this. I desperately need to get my hair cut. I desperately need to get my hair cut. I can also say, I get my hair cut every 6 weeks. Okay? Or I have my hair cut every 6 weeks. Because if we use this in a more direct way and say, I cut my hair every 6 weeks, I need to cut my hair, it suggests that I am going to do it. Which, by the way, I used to do. I used to cut my own hair for about 6 years. And then I decided I should go and get my hair cut instead. I should go to a hairdresser's and get my hair cut. So going back to this, I desperately need to get my hair cut. I need to get the car fixed soon. We can use have here. I need to have the car fixed soon. I desperately need to have my hair cut. But from my experience, it's a little more common to use get. I need to get the car fixed soon. I need to get my hair cut soon. Okay, go to the comment section. Are you an experienced car mechanic? I know nothing about cars. My knowledge of cars is zero. I don't care about cars. I just want my car to be efficient, comfortable, and reliable. Three great ways to explain. Okay, efficient, which means you don't spend a lot of money on petrol or gas. Comfortable, which just means, you know, it's the seats are comfortable, it just feels nice. And reliable, which means it doesn't break down that often. But I don't care about cars. Kwan here, I have to get my eyebrows done. Fantastic example. I have to get my eyebrows done. It just means that someone is going to do this for you, to get someone to do something for you. I've got another example soon. Jose, when you do this live, you speak at the same rhythm than your average day. I'm going to talk about that at the end. A lot of people ask me about this. What kind of car do you like? You see, I don't really care. I'm sorry. I don't really care about cars. It's just not something that I really care about. But let's look at one more example, okay? We get a lot of things delivered. And I might just change that slightly. We get a lot of things delivered these days, okay? We get a lot of things delivered these days. So instead of buying toilet paper, we have toilet paper delivered. We get it delivered. We do this through Amazon. We get a lot of things delivered instead of going to the store and buying them. One of these things, I think that's going to change for the future. I think more people will get things delivered moving forward. More people are going to get everyday items delivered moving forward. So we get a lot of things delivered these days. I desperately need to get my hair cut. By the way, do I desperately need to get my hair cut? I think it's okay at the moment. But I desperately need to get my hair cut. I need to get the car fixed soon. Get someone to do something for us. Or get something done for us. You'll notice that we use the verb fixed, cut, delivered here as well. I'll leave these sentences in the comment section, in the description below. Moving on. Have a look at this. Did you guys watch this lesson? Did you watch this conversation between me and my wife? This is the third one we have done recently. And we talked about love. We talked about love. I did that on my Instagram video yesterday, and some people liked that. By the way, my phone is going crazy. I'm getting so many messages and phone calls, but nothing important. Hopefully nothing important. I am going to meet my friend in about an hour. And I might just need to arrange that during this live lesson. I'll see if I can do that. I'll see if I can multitask. So moving back to this. Did you guys watch that live lesson? Let's have a look. I'm just going to read some more comments. Today I got my parcel delivered. Can I say I need to get surgery soon? Yeah, I need to have surgery done soon. That's what people say. I need to have some surgery done. Or I need to have surgery. A lot of the time we just say that. I need to have surgery. I think it's fine, but you can get shaved sides. Yeah, to get it shorter here. Today I am fasting and I need to get breakfast. I talked about fasting, didn't I, in one of my recent lessons. A lot of people watched it. It's a nice video. Francisco is here from España. Where in Spain are you from? Colorball is here from Czech Republic. Very cool. I need to get some chocolate very soon. So this is just like, I need to buy some chocolate. I need to get some chocolate. Aledo is here from Brazil. I can't quite read names. It's very small today. And Camilo is here from Colombia. Colombia. Where in Colombia? I went to Medellin and Cartagena, Santa Marta, Taganga. Yeah, had a great time there. Do you miss England? Not too much. Not too much at the moment. Although it's, you know, sometimes. Back to this. Okay. In this video, we talked about love. We talked about soulmates. Having a crush on someone. Going on a first date. And we also talked about this. Online dating. And I said, or my wife said, I can't remember. Online dating is a big thing now. Online dating is a big thing now. And this just means online dating is popular. It's something that people do. And I talked about how I used to go on to online dating websites when I was 22, 23, after university. And I don't want to talk about it too much, but things have changed. Things have changed. And this is used in the present perfect to talk about how things have changed over time. Okay, so things have changed. When I did online dating, there were no apps on your phone. Okay, we didn't have apps on our phone. But now it's all about the apps. Okay. Things like Tinder. People use Tinder to do online dating. And it's such a big thing now. Like, people use it all the time. And what I thought we'd do in this lesson, for part of this lesson, is look at some stats about online dating. And I got these from a website. I'll leave the link to that website below so you can read the full article. It's a great article because it uses simple English. And you'll be able to learn a lot from it. But let's just quickly read this one. So read this on your screen now, and then I'm going to read it for you all. Okay, online dating has lost much of its stigma. And a majority of Americans now say online dating is a good way to meet people. So we have the word stigma here. Okay, stigma. And it is stigma. What it means is it suggests that, like, there's some kind of bad thing about it. So there's some kind of bad thing associated with it. And a good example is, if you say online dating, some people go, ooh. And that suggests that there's a stigma attached to it. So in the past, there was this stigma about online dating. People used to think, ooh, that's dangerous. Or, oh, are you desperate? Or, why would you do that? Just meet people in bars. Those were the type of responses people used to have about online dating. Like, ooh, why are you doing that? Why are you doing that? But like this article says, online dating has lost much of its stigma. So when people say, you know, I use online dating websites, people usually respond and say, oh, that's cool. How's it working? And everyone knows people who does this now. So online dating has lost much of its stigma. And a majority of Americans now say online dating is a good way to meet people. So the majority of people now say online dating is a great way to meet people. Let's bring the comment section up. Tinder is quite popular. Unfortunately, I only get one swipe match. I don't understand what that means, but it sounds like you can't use it that much. Rosa says bad reputation. Yeah, if something has a stigma attached to it, it just means like there's some kind of bad reputation. People don't like feel comfortable with it. A good example is in America, there's not as much of a stigma about drink driving. Whereas in the UK, there's a lot of stigma attached to this. And in the UK, if you say, if you drink two beers and you go to drive, everyone will say, stop, what the hell are you doing? Don't do that. In America, people do it. It's more accepted, if that makes sense. Bassam, keep the questions on topic. Keep the questions on topic. Jack, your videos are helping so much with listening. Oh, thank you so much. It's so good to have people here. We've got someone from Iran, which is great. I share your link on HelloTalk. I hope you get a lot of people. Yeah, guys, if you're enjoying this lesson, thumbs up and share. Thumbs up and share. Share with people. It's really going to help me. Thank you. I'm glad that... Oh, the quality is really good too. Fantastic. So online dating has lost much of its stigma, and a majority of Americans now say online dating is a great way to meet people. Here's for you. Online dating has jumped among adults under age 25, as well as those in their late 50s and early 60s. So online dating has jumped among adults under age 25, as well as those in their late 50s and early 60s. And this is a great stat because we're using the word jumped. And again, we're using the present perfect to talk about a change over time. Online dating has jumped. It has increased dramatically. It has jumped among adults under age 25, as well as those in their late 50s and early 60s. So it's become more popular for people under 25 and for those who are in their 50s and 60s. Quick question, okay? Have you ever tried online dating? This is a very personal question here. A very personal question. But just a quick yes or no in the live chat. It will be interesting to see if you have tried this before. I have. I told you before. I'm now happily married, so I don't use these dating websites. But I tried it in the past. Have you ever tried online dating? Because it's becoming more popular. And like we saw before, most Americans see this as a good way to meet new people. Have you tried online dating? Have you tried online dating? Ilkin says, on Tinder, you swipe right to like someone, and if the person swipes right too, it matches you, and you'll have a chance to direct message that person. Very cool. We've got someone saying yes, no, yes, Fanny, yes. A few people have tried this, more than I thought. Some thumbs up, which I don't know if that means that you have tried online dating, or you're giving this video the thumbs up. People are probably being shy about this and they don't want to say. I've tried it, but it was terrible. Ivness says, no, I haven't, but I would. I see no problem with it. Great phrase. I haven't tried it, but I would do it. I haven't tried it, but I would do it. No, I have online dated quite a lot and I'm talking about hundreds. Ilkin, fantastic. You can give us all some tips about how best to date online. We had no. I tried Tinder and I have a great friend from there. Have you ever online dated, Jack? Amir, I just told you I have. Good job. Good to have you here, Amir, by the way. Thank you for sharing my videos a lot. Yes, I don't think so. I've never, but I wouldn't mind doing it. Yes, I met a person personally, but it didn't work well. Yes, a long time ago. It doesn't go with Muslim culture. Yeah, in some cultures, it might not really match. I learn a lot from your videos. Thank you. It's not my cup of tea. Pedja, fantastic comment. If you say it's not my cup of tea, it means it doesn't really suit me, you know. Baseball's not my cup of tea. I don't really like baseball. But that's interesting. A lot of people have tried online dating, and someone said that they met a friend through online dating, because I've noticed other websites and other apps in the App Store, and also on Facebook as like an advertisement saying, this is the Tinder for business people. And you can meet, you know, people for friends using online apps now. So you can meet like-minded people and, you know, let's say you both have children and you can say, let's get together at one point. You know, you seem nice, we're nice, let's meet. And I feel like this is going to become more popular, where especially when you move to a new city and you don't know anyone, it's just an easy way to meet people. And online apps and things like that are changing the way we see and make new relationships. Very good. Okay, here's something else. 1/3 of people who have used online dating have never actually gone on a date with someone they met on these sites. This is some great language here. 1/3 of people who have used online dating, so we're talking about a statistic, have never actually gone on a date with someone they met on these sites. So we're using, we talked about in that conversational lesson to go on a date. And when we're using it in the present perfect, never, have never gone on a date. Okay? And we said, I've never gone on a blind date with someone. I've never gone on a blind date with someone. So 1/3 of people who've used these dating sites have never actually gone on a date with someone. So this shows that, you know, not everyone, or 1/3 of people, never actually go on a date with someone. And that seems to be quite common from the chat box. I'll bring up the comment section again. This is a brilliant video from Sudan. Thank you for being here. Sir Tixera, I tried online dating before, but it didn't really work well. Oh, it didn't really work as well as I thought it was going to. So I've tried online dating before, but it didn't work as well as I thought it was going to. Sorry, I'm just reading the comment. Ilkan, cup of tea and piece of cake, those expressions mean the same, right, Jack? No, if something's a piece of cake, it means it's easy. You know, you can say it for anything. You know, this video, or understanding this video, is a piece of cake. I live in the UK. My friend who found Tinder is an Indian, and I can practice English with him. Yeah, I once talked about, actually it's inside my course, I talk about how you can use these websites as a way to practice your English. If you're single, you can use these websites to meet people who are English speakers. But it's not just online dating websites, it's things like meetup.com, Couchsurfing. There are other websites too where you can make friends with English speakers. And if you are single, if you're open to it, then you can use online dating to practice your English. It's a great way. I know some people who met online and got married. Well, Anna, thank you for bringing that up, because that's the next thing we're going to talk about. 5% of Americans who are in a marriage or a committed relationship say they met their significant other online. So their significant other means their boyfriend or their husband, their wife, their girlfriend. 5% of Americans who are currently in a marriage or committed relationship say they met their significant other online. It's quite a high amount of people. So 5% of people in America who are married or in a relationship met online. It's kind of cool, I feel. And that percentage is going to get higher and higher. This percentage might jump in the future as more people use online dating sites. So one of the verbs that we've used a lot in this lesson is meet. To meet, your husband, to meet your wife, to meet your girlfriend, to meet someone. You'll hear people say things like, it's hard to meet people these days, or it's hard to meet people in your 30s. It's hard to meet people when you have children. Okay, so we're using that verb meet to talk about the first time we, you know, connect with someone. But just to go back to this, 5% of Americans who are in a marriage or committed relationship say they met their significant other online. It's kind of cool. Comments of the week. I feel like I need to have music and jingles in these live lessons. So when I introduce a new segment, I should introduce some music and say things like, comment of the week. Comment of the week is from Dr. Rajani Soraka, and she commented on the video that I talked about before. Thanks a lot, Jack, Kate, and Emma, for a wonderful lesson and tips on Valentine's Day in advance. It's always great to see you guys. Yes, I do believe in the soulmate concept. At the same time, I think relationships are maintained with respect, commitment, and responsibility. Wishing you a happy Valentine's Day. Stay blessed. Lots of love to Emma. So in that video, I asked the question of, do you believe in soulmates? Do you believe in this concept of soulmates, that there's only one person for you? Okay? That's the idea of a soulmate. There's only one person for you and you have to meet them. But Dr. Rajani talks about, yes, I believe in that, but at the same time, you need to have respect in your relationship, you need to have commitment, and you need to be able to take responsibility. There's also something else that people talked about, and that's what we're going to talk about now. Because, did you watch this video? I look happy in that video. This was a Facebook Live lesson from Tuesday? Yeah, Tuesday. And you can watch my live lessons on Facebook if you go to facebook.com/tofluency. facebook.com/tofluency. Did you watch this live lesson? Let me know. Because in that lesson, I talked about this. We had a little conversation about this. To take someone or something for granted. To take someone or something for granted. Okay. And this just means to not appreciate someone. So if you take someone for granted, it's like you don't appreciate them. And it's usually because of this time that you've been together. So to talk about it in a relationship, sometimes it's hard to appreciate the other person after 5 years or 6 years of being together. Sometimes it's hard to appreciate, you know, how great a person they are, or what they do for you, or how lucky you are to be with that person. So when you take someone for granted, it's that failure to recognize this, to appreciate that person. Let's just go to the comment section again. Having music and a jingle would be awesome. The importance of put the time into the live lessons. Yeah, I just like to make it fun. You know, I feel like I need to put some music into this. A lot of people, some people watched it, some people didn't. I did watch it. Yeah, so a lot of people watched it. Great. And like I said, we talked about to take someone for granted, because when we're chips and to maintain a relationship over the long term, it's important that we don't take people for granted. But we can also take things for granted too. But first, here's just an example. He takes her for granted. Okay? It's a very simple sentence, but that's how we use it. He takes her for granted. He takes her for granted. I sometimes take it for granted that I live in a great house. I sometimes take it for granted that I live in a great house. And I feel like the reason why we take things for granted is because we become very familiar to them. So we become familiar with the people we're hanging around. We become familiar with, you know, what we have in our lives. We become familiar with the people that we are in relationships with. And it's very easy to take things for granted and to take people for granted as well. And the opposite of that is gratitude, where you feel so grateful for what you have. You feel grateful for the people that you're with, for your family, for your friends, for your situation, for the things that you have. So I've got a quick question for you. What do you take for granted, or what do you sometimes take for granted? It could be big, it could be small, but I'm really interested to see your comments here, just to see what you take for granted. And like I say, it's when you fail to appreciate someone or something, mainly because you are very familiar with that person or with that thing. You have become used to that situation. Let's bring up the comment section. Someone says, is it in a bad sense? Yeah, it's usually, we usually use this to talk about it in a, you know, in a negative way, I guess. If someone says he takes her for granted, it's saying like this person doesn't appreciate his wife or girlfriend. And it's used in that negative sense. It's this failure to appreciate something. It's this failure to do this. And it's not an easy question to answer. Gemma, it's good to have you. I usually take my friends for granted. I should pay more attention to them. Sometimes I take my good health for granted. This is such a fantastic example. When we are in good health, when we don't have any health problems, we take it for granted. And it's this feeling of when we do get sick, okay, that's when we appreciate the fact that, you know, we are normally healthy. You know, when you're feeling terrible, and let's just say you have the flu, in that moment you think, oh, I'm so grateful that, generally speaking, I'm healthy and I don't have this big problem. You know, sometimes we take our health for granted. It's such a good example. At times, I take my mum for granted, even though I try not to. Yeah, it's this familiarity with someone. Don't take our planet for granted because we may lose it from pollution. Great example. We take it for granted that, you know, we have this one Earth. You know, we take it for granted. I used to take my friends for granted. Great, using it in the past, a past habit. I used to take my friends for granted. These comments are so kind today. You guys have been so nice. I think I take it for granted the fact that I have the opportunity of going to college when lots of people can't afford it. Great example. So if you have the opportunity to go to college, then you can take this for granted. We should not take our relationships for granted. I usually take my husband for granted and know that it's no good for our relationship. You guys, these comments, they're incredible. They're incredible. I take my car for granted sometimes, but on rainy days, I feel I'm lucky to have it. I've taken all these past years for granted. These examples will help you understand exactly how we use it. So everyone who's left a comment, thank you so much. Thank you so much. We're going to move on to the pronunciation side of things now, okay? Because I had this comment on one of my videos from F Crazybone. The British pronunciation of Twitter is quite amusing. How they stress the T sound. Okay. This British pronunciation of Twitter is quite amusing. How they pronounce the T sound. Now, the idea is this. In American English, you'll hear people say Twitter, Twitter, Twitter. There are a couple of differences here. Firstly, notice that D sound in the middle, Twitter, Twitter. And it's like a soft D, Twitter, Twitter. And also, in most American English, people will hit that R sound at the end, Twitter, Twitter. Whereas in British pronunciation, Twitter, Twitter. We use the schwa at the end, but we also hit the T, Twitter, Twitter. Okay, Twitter, 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 Twitter. My American English is really good these days. In fact, so my wife says that I have the worst American accent, but when I was in the car yesterday, and when it was broken down, I called one of the local garages to say, hey, if the car is broken down, can we have it towed to you today to have something done? Can we have it towed to you today? So this is when the truck will attach to the car and tow the car. It will tow the car. So can we have it towed to you guys today? And I'm not going to do the impression, but he had a very strong southern accent. So then I called my wife and I copied what he said in his accent. And she said, that sounds really good. And she is telling me that I'm getting better at accents. I'm trying. But let's focus. Twitter, Twitter. Twitter, Twitter. So you can see there's quite a big difference here. And I have a few more for you for when Americans use that D sound. Katie. 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 And then in British, Katie. Katie. Katie, Katie. Katie, Katie. So you can see the difference here. And what's interesting is my wife used to go by Katie. That's what people called her. Okay, her name is Catherine, but people called her Katie. She used to go by Katie. But then she changed it to Kate. Kate. So, in the past, I used to say Katie. And her friends used to smile because of that British T sound. Her friends called her Katie. Katie. So you can see the difference. I've got a couple more for you in a second. British is almost the same that we as we say it here in Brazil, Twitter. I don't know why people don't like the British accent. It's so beautiful and good to listen to. Yeah. Gemma has the opposite. I love the way Americans pronounce it. I always pronounce it with my American accent, which drives my teachers up the wall. Yeah, a great idiom here. To drive your teachers up the wall, to drive your teachers crazy. Yes, teachers should be open to whatever accent you have. It's a little bit frustrating that. Camilo, you are boring me. Camilo. Great phrase, though. We can use this in this way. You are boring me. Oh, you are boring me. And it's just to say, you know, this lesson isn't very exciting. I disagree. I prefer the British accent, but most of the time I sound American. I like the British tea more than the American tea. That's Estella from Argentina. Okay. Katie, Katie. Water, water. Water, water. Water, water. So this is, again, the British example here is using that T sound, but also we're using the schwa at the end. Water, water. American English, water, water. And this is where servers in restaurants get really confused. Because I say, just a water, please. Okay. Do you guys want anything to drink? Just a water, please. They say, what? Just a water. They don't know what I'm saying because of this difference in pronunciation. So what I normally do now is I say, just a water, please. And I just make it sound American so then they understand me. So water, water. Sorry about my microphone. Here's another example, and then I have a really good example. Bottle, bottle. Bottle, bottle. Bottle, bottle. My favorite, water bottle. Water bottle. Sorry, it makes me laugh when I try to do the American accent. Okay, let's do this seriously. Water bottle? Water bottle. One thing my wife does say is that I sound like a robot when I try to do American English. Water bottle. I'm sorry. Let's do the British one. Water bottle. Water bottle. Water bottle. So you can see the difference there with the T and the D sound. And this sounds really different, doesn't it? Water bottle. Water bottle. Water bottle. Sounds really different. And hopefully I'm doing the American accent well enough so you can understand. Just a water. Yeah, Amir, look at that. That's what I said before. Just a water, please. So if someone says, what would you guys still like to drink? Just a water, please. And that's something that that is common in America, okay? When we lived in Spain, it was quite strange because when you asked for a water, they would bring you like a sparkling water. But in America, they just always bring you water. So even if you ask for wine or a beer, they'll bring you water as well. Adrian says, what about the memory card on the door behind you? Yeah, I made a video about this because I kept forgetting my memory card. So I left a little note on the side up here to say memory card so that I wouldn't forget it. So that I wouldn't forget it. Fantastic. Yeah, so Texa, British people don't open their mouth enough to say words like I can't. Yeah, that's a big difference between British and American. My wife always tells me or makes fun of me when I say I can't. In American English, I can't. So you can see the difference there. Camilo says, I was kidding about my last comment. Yeah, be nice. But I'm glad that you're kidding. Mohammed has left there a tongue twister. Betty Botter bought some butter, but she said this butter's bitter. If I put my... Yeah, so Betty Botter bought some butter. Betty Botter bought some butter. So you can see the difference there. I'm going to do that. It's a really good example. I'm going to read a couple more comments. I like to hear the British accent, but I don't like to speak with the British accent. Amir says, this happened to me in the UK. I asked for water. He brought me a white wine. That's funny. Very cool. Well, let's get some questions for me ready. This is when you can ask me any kind of questions, okay, within reason, be nice. But we're going to do that in a second. But first, complete the sentences. My computer, I nearly said it, my computer, something, turn on. We use this in the past. Yesterday, my computer, something, turn on. And this is from the lesson today. Again, I should have some music as we go into the section for practice. My computer, something, turn on. 3, 2, 1. My computer wouldn't turn on. My computer wouldn't turn on. She's going to leave him because he takes her. She's going to leave him because he takes her. Complete that sentence. three, two, one. She's going to leave him because he takes her for granted. And I use this one because we're using a lot of these, you know, awkward words. To leave him because he takes her. And it's great to practice this. She's going to leave him because he takes her for granted. Online dating is to meet new people. This one might be a little bit more difficult, but try to use it from the lesson. Online dating is there are two words here, to meet new people. And we used this one before. Three, two, one. Online dating is a great way to meet new people. Online dating is a great way to meet new people. Very good. So, guys, bring in your comments. Let's just have a look. A lot of people have that for granted. Bassem, I'm sorry. I'm going to have to... Bassem, your comments are not good today. For granted, a great way, good way. Yeah, we can use a great way or good way. A new way. Great opportunity. People are getting very... Very creative here, which is great. Great opportunity. Yeah, great or good way is what I was looking for. Fantastic. So, guys, question and answer time. If you guys have any questions that you want to ask me that I would like to answer, I'm just going to do a couple of things. Okay. If you guys have any questions that you want to ask me about anything really, then let's do this. Ask me questions about learning English, about me, about these lessons, about this lesson, about this office, about outside, about anything. You can ask me questions about anything. And while you're thinking about those questions, okay, a couple of things. If you do not have my book yet, you need to get this to fluency.com/book. It's free. It's called The 5-Step Plan for English Fluency. And it shows you exactly how to create a fluency plan, how to create a plan for your English. And I talk about time management. I talk about goals. I talk about motivation. And I also talk about the best ways to learn English. The best ways to learn English. So go to fluency.com/book. There'll be a link in the description. And if you're watching this live, there'll be a link at the end to fluency.com/book, and you'll be able to download it for free. If you want my premium lessons and you want to download audio files, memory cards, and really go into depth in terms of how to learn English, then go to fluency.com/TFP, to fluency.com/TFP. It's a fluency program. I've just uploaded the premium materials from this lesson, where there are 99 fluency phrases that you can download and that you can master. So you can master these fluency phrases from this video that we made the other day. And yeah, it'll be a great thing for you to do. To fluency.com/TFP. Check it out. Okay, question time. This is my favorite part. What are key differences between living in the UK and the USA? There's quite a lot of differences, to be honest. And I made a video on this where I talk about some of the key cultural differences. And in fact, my wife and I are going to make a lesson on this because, you know, we have experience of living in the UK and the US. She's American, I'm British. And we can really go into depth with this. But I think one of the big differences, people in America can be more confident, they can be louder, things like that. British people are a little bit more reserved. And also British people have a different sense of humour. It's a little bit drier, but And that's hard to explain. But I also know a lot of Americans who have, you know, a dry sense of humour too. So it's hard to say sometimes, but I think confidence is one of the big ones. I'm going to go back up. Is there a fixed day time for these live lessons? Thank you, Franklin. Good to see you again. Yeah, every Wednesday at 10:30, except for today, because I had to cancel the lesson yesterday. What's the difference between two and also? I don't really know from the top of my head. I can't teach that in a good way right now. What makes you most frustrated and why? I think this is the same for a lot of people. You can be a very calm person. You can be relaxed. But when you get in a car, you can get very frustrated. Or when you're, you know, a pedestrian, you can get frustrated. I got frustrated yesterday because we tried to cross the road on a zebra crossing and two cars came bombing down the road, which means they came very fast down the road and didn't even see us trying to cross the road. And it's just so dangerous. So I get frustrated in the car. I get frustrated when people don't indicate. When, you know, in a car, if you want to go right, you put your indicator on and it flashes like this. People don't do that here in America. It's really frustrating. These small things, I guess. What accent do you speak? Are you from Northern England? Yeah, I am from Preston, Lancashire, England. Very close to Manchester. My accent is a Northern English accent, but it's a little bit more neutral than what it was. Why the switches don't... I don't... How can I increase my vocabulary? Go to fluency.com/sentence method. I'll leave a link in the description. Have you ever tried to speak Portuguese? Yeah, I did this on a live Facebook lesson where I spoke in different languages. I know very little Portuguese, and hopefully I'm doing that okay. But yeah, I'm going to learn some phrases soon. Whew, that's a big question. I'm going to pick and choose. Grateful and thankful, what's the difference? And this is Coina. Not a big difference. I'm very thankful about this. I'm very grateful about this. I don't really know if there's a big difference between those two. See. How do you always stay happy and positive? I'm grateful. So when we talked about taking things for granted, I specifically work on things. I specifically write down every day what I'm grateful for. And this is not just in a, you know, a quick way, but it's actually, you know, I feel it. And people talk about how this practice of gratitude helps you just feel happy. And it does. It helps me. And there's something that you can think about here. You can be grateful for what you have, but you can still want to improve. So when it comes to, I'll make a video about this. When it comes to learning English, you know, a lot of people feel, oh, my level's terrible. I feel bad about my English. I don't feel confident. And when you have that attitude, it's very difficult to be in a good place, to feel happy. But if you say, for example, I am very grateful to have the level I have right now, but I want to improve it. And that's a great mentality to have. I'll make a video about this. I think it's a really good topic. ¿Hablas español, Jack? Sí, pero hace mucho tiempo que no hablo en español y no tengo muchas oportunidades de hablar. Pero escucho mucho. It's been a while since I spoke Spanish, but I want to do more Spanish. What's the difference between I can't stand her and how do you put up with her? So it's just, yeah, if you say I can't stand her, then what you're saying is you really don't like this person. How can you put up with her? This suggests that somebody is in a relationship that where the girl that they're with is horrible or terrible, how can you put up with her? She's so mean to you. How can you put up with her? She's crazy. How can you put up with her? So it's saying, how can you stay in a relationship even though, you know, there's something wrong? How is your French now? Très bien, très bien. Je parle français. No, it's not very good, but I am practicing all the time. How often do you hear and use the idiom? Let's get down to brass tacks. Is it what? I can't remember what that is. Brass, I think it's tacks. Let's get down to brass tacks. I had no idea. Sometimes you hear an idiom and you don't know what it is. Brass tacks. Let's get down to brass tacks. This is used for specific situations in business. So you would use this in a business meeting. And yeah, it's not used that much. You'll see this in films, but from my experience, it's best not to use this. You know, you can just say like, okay, shall we talk about the project? Okay, let's talk about the project. Okay, let's talk about this contract. Let's get down to the project. Let's get down to the contract. It's more common to say this. Did you fix your car? I hope so. The car started, it worked, but we might still have a problem with it. How was it for you to get used to the American system of inches and feet? Well, in the UK, it's a mixture. We use a mile. We don't use kilometres. We use a pint as well for beer. We don't use litres. We use feet and inches. We don't use kilograms. No, feet and inches. We don't use metres and centimetres. We use stone, okay? 12 stone. We don't use pounds and whatever it is, or kilograms. So a lot of it I'm already used to. I'm used to miles, I'm used to feet and inches. So yeah, it's just one of those things. Just reading the comments. So many comments here. Louise, good to have you here, Louise. I was listening in the car before you started. And I noticed a slight American way of how you say Tuesday. Does your family think you sound more American now? Yeah, this is one of those things. Like, another difference between British and American pronunciation. And by the way, Louise, it's so good to see you. Tuesday, Tuesday. Tuna, tuna. And I've started just to say things like Tuesday instead of Tuesday. Again, it's when you live in a place for a long time and you hear the way things are pronounced, then you just get used to it. You internalize it a little bit. So yeah, I say things like Tuesday, and I'm starting to use the American T, like butter, more. It's just one of those things. Do you like Netflix original series? The Crown is amazing. Or The Crown is awesome. Yeah, my wife watched The Crown. She really liked it. I haven't seen it. We really like Stranger Things. Netflix American series, or Netflix series, are great. You know, so many great series. Someone has a question here. Do you help your wife? Do you help your wife? With what? I'd love to know. What does it mean to be bilingual? I think this is where you can, you know, you have a proficient command of two languages. I think that's the idea. I'm going to read that comment. I think I'm going to go now, because we've gone for over an hour. We've gone for an hour, which is incredible. So guys, if you have watched this lesson, if you're still watching, thank you so much for being here. If you're watching the replay, it's great to have you. Check out the description and I'll tell you how you can watch these lessons live. Let's just talk a little bit again about what you need to get if you don't have it already. I talked about, firstly, my book, If you don't have it, to fluency.com/book. It's free to download. You just enter your details. I'll send it to you in an email, and you can read it on any device. It's free to read, and you're going to get a lot out of it. Again, if you want fluency phrases, if you want memory cards, if you want to really make a difference to your speaking, like Sally does, asking about how he can or she can improve his or her speaking, and go to the TIFF Fluency program, to fluency.com/TFP. We have fluency phrases, we have memory cards, we have so many materials for you to improve your English. So again, thank you so much for being here. Please share this video with anyone who would find it useful. Share it on Facebook, share it on HelloTalk, someone did that before, on WhatsApp, by email, on Google+, on Twitter, all those things. Thank you again for being here, and I'll see you all next week. I might have a couple of videos before then. Bye for now.